Hey, how you doing? Andy with you for another lesson. Today we're taking a look at Little Lion Man by Mumford and Sons. I only heard this about 3 days ago and really top song, really enjoy it and have been listening to it maybe a little bit too much. So I'm going to dig into it before it drives me crazy and show you how to play it. So what we're going to do first of all is take a look at the chords that are going on. I'm doing this out as like a sort of solo arrangement, so putting the other instruments as much as I can into this the guitar parts that I've got going on here, so as to not just do just the guitar. So here's what we've got. We've got A minor. We've got an A minor with a flat 13. Sounds scary, but all it is just barring out that first finger down the bottom. So we end up getting second fret, first fret, first fret. We've got C, we've got G, F, you can do this as a small version or the full bar version, I'm going to do it that way, and we've also got these little other bits in there as well, which I'll show you as we go. Apart from that, I think that's basically it, so there's only a few chords going on. So looking at the verse section, here's our rhythm, it's like this. Bass, strum, up, down. Bass, strum, up, down. So that's what we got going on there. If you have trouble getting that going to start with, you can try this. Bass, strum, down, up, down. Filling in that gap in between. So bass, strum, down, up, down. Then work towards miss. Getting that little miss in there. That's the step that you want to take. So, now that we've got our strumming rhythm, we can then start moving through the chart that I've got there for you. If you haven't got that already, you might want to grab that to follow through. It'll make things easier. So, and the 13. Then we're on to the C. And we're going to do that rhythm again. Except the second half, we're going to get this. We're going to take our second finger, put it on the G, second fret. And then we're going to go open, and then we're going to do the same on the D string, second fret, and then we're going to take that off. Now, what strings I'm hitting here is somewhat sort of approximate. You don't have to get the exact same strings every time. It's a loose sort of feel. But the thing that you want to hear inside of this is this melody. So what we're aiming for is... So far, here's what we've got for the verse. Now, that's pretty speedy. It'll take a while to build it up. When I was working through playing with the song, I don't do a lot of this sort of bluegrassy sort of, you know, busy rhythms and stuff. And, you know, it was quite straining. I had to really get my hand to loosen up to be able to do these at the high speeds. So takes a bit of practice. So from there, the next part of the verse is G, F, and then from there, we now have what is sort of some little bass notes, and this is the stuff that I'm talking about, putting the other parts, the other instruments into the guitar part. Originally, the guitar is just sitting on F, C. What we want to do for that second half of F is get this. We're going to flip over to what would be like a C shape here, except we're going to get just the first finger, and we're going to get this walking bass line. Leading back to our C chord. So we're going to take the second fret on the D, open, and then back to your C. And the rhythm that we're going to get for that is down, down, up, down, down, up. So we're from F, so it takes a little bit to kind of get used to with the changing of the rhythms there. So I'll play all the way from the G so you can get a feel. Cool, so there is our verse so far. Onto the chorus, we have A minor, F, C. Now this pops up slightly different at different times. Sometimes you get just a single hit on the A, depending on whether they're doing sort of just the a cappella vocal thing, or whether they're doing hits, or whether it's rolling through. So the very first time, when it's It's not your fault, but mine, when your heart's on the line. So I'm going to do it for the, say, the second chorus where everything's rolling through and we don't have any stops. So same rhythm again. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, A minor, F, C. Cool. So there is essentially your chorus. So then for the breakdown, you're going to go back to just your A minor and C for a little bit, which is really, really soft. There's just a lot of ambience going on. From there, we're then going to kick in to the build-up section, which you could also call the bridge section. What we're going to do here is a little more straight-ahead rhythm. It's all downstrokes pretty much. We're going to get strum, bass, strum, bass, strum, bass, strum, then down up. So we get 1, 2, 3, 4, down up. Little strum on the end there. And we're going to get that every bar as we move through these sections. So the chords are G, C, and F. So I'm going to move through that and guide you through it. Etc. Now that goes through all up, we've got 8 times, but what happens is it changes over on the 6th time when we get to the F back to the old rhythm. So it'd be like this on the 6th time. And we're going to flip back. Etc. So we're going to continue with that rhythm for the very last 2 rounds, so the 7th and the 8th round, and then you're back into your chorus again, etc. So pretty challenging on the speed. Apart from that, just getting the feel of these rhythms here. If you have any hassles with this, check out my lesson on rhythms that I've got over at Nail Guitar Skills, and that should help you out if you have any problems with what's going on there so far. Now, I'm going to give you a bit of a backing track that you can have a run through with that. It is up to full speed. Let me know if you like these backing tracks or not. I want to get some feedback. You know, do you want backing tracks or do you not really care? That sort of thing. And slowdowns. Do you want slowdowns for songs, or you're just happy to, you know, just get your tab, or you're happy for me to just, you know, give you the lesson, that sort of thing. So I'd love a bit of feedback there. All right, so there it is. Cool little song to add to your collection, and good for building up your speed. And yeah, you can also get the download MP3 for the backing track as well at nailguitar.com. So enjoy that, have fun with it, and I will catch you for another lesson soon.